most people don't make impact in the world is because they are too busy and committed to making a living as to living they are making.
Wow.
As to living they are making. We are too busy making a living than living our making. What is your making? What is your why? What is it? What have you been created to do? I remember in the year 2018, the Holy Spirit spoke to me. He said, get up and get ready for the assignment I have for you. Get up and get ready for the assignment I have for you. Precisely, he said, begin to work on yourself. Begin to prepare yourself. So it's very, very important for us to spend the rest of our life living our making. When you begin to focus on what God has created you to do by running a vision that is in line with your purpose, your life will be meaningful. The only way to head for the future is through a genuine vision. The only way to head for the future is through a genuine vision. I mean, a genuine vision. Vision that is birthed out of God's plan and purpose for your life. We are not talking about destructive vision. We want vision that will bring a blessing to our generation. A vision that will make us to be impactful. And one other thing I would like us to also know is this. The fact that you are educated, the fact that you have money, is not enough to live a fulfilling life. If you lack vision, you have money, you are educated. If you don't have vision, your life is going to be miserable. We know there are a lot of rich folks out there who are living miserable lives because they have no vision. Because they have no vision. Napoleon Hill said, more gold has been mined from the thoughts of men than has ever been taken from the earth. More gold has been mined from the thoughts of men than has ever been taken from the earth. That is through the power of thinking. You begin to think about your future. You begin to think about what God has shown you. We're talking about vision is about thinking. Vision is about planning and having an imagination of a successful future, a glorious future. And when you talk about planning, Jenny Rice said, I will do today what others won't do in order to have tomorrow what others won't have. I will do today what others won't do in order to have tomorrow what others won't have. That is the power of planning. A man with a vision, a man that is running with God's vision for his life, is thinking, is planning, and is having an imagination. Because I tell people, if you read what others don't read, you will know what others don't know. If you study what others don't study, you will know what others don't know. So I will do today what others won't do in order to have tomorrow what others will not have. So it's very, very important. And planning, we say, is the process of thinking about the activities required to achieve the desired goals. Thinking about the activities required to achieve the desired goals. That is planning. You sit down and you begin to think. There's something you want to achieve. There's a life you want to live. Whatever it is, then you begin to think about the steps to take. That is planning. You are thinking about the steps to take to enable you to achieve the desired goal. Planning is important for personal, social, economical, financial, national, career, and business development. In any aspect of your life, planning is inevitable. Planning is inevitable. Let's quickly go forward to what we need to know about our vision. What we need to know about our vision. It's crucial that we begin to live. Ambition is different from vision. Ambition is different from vision. I want us to clear that right now. Ambition is different from vision. Ambition is living to meet your personal needs, while vision is living to impact people, community, and the generation. Ambition is living to meet your personal needs, while vision is living to impact people, community, and generations. Ambition is living to meet your personal needs, while vision is living to impact people, community, and your generation. So a man of vision is not thinking about himself alone. A man of vision is thinking about how to make the world a wonderful place for people to live. Vision is the key to living a meaningful life. Vision is the key to living a meaningful life. Do you want to live a meaningful life? You must have a vision. The vision that you live by. These are things that are really guiding your life. You are running with that vision. The vision that you have is what will help you to live a meaningful life. Vision is the desire to change a major situation in the world. Vision is the desire to change a major situation in the world. There's chaos out there. There are a lot of problems out there. And I believe you could be one of the people who will be transforming our world. I believe, I have no doubt about that. So with the help of the vision that God has given you, you are bringing a change into the world. With the help of the vision that God has given you, you are bringing a change to the world. This great man, Warren Buffett, said, he said, you are sitting under the tree because somebody planted that tree long ago. You are sitting under a tree because somebody planted that tree long ago. I'm just trying to paraphrase. That is to say, when you solve a problem, you are making people to be able to live, to benefit from what you have done. From what you have done. So vision helps us to live a meaningful life and to help us to bring about a change in a major situation in the world. Vision creates more opportunities to solve problems. It creates more opportunities to solve problems. So that is it. Your vision should be able to solve a problem in your locality, in your nation, and even in the world at large. Vision is the capacity to believe what you cannot see. Nevertheless, you are preparing for it. Vision is the ability, is the capacity, is the faith behind the driving force in your life. Is the ability to believe what you cannot see, but nevertheless, you are preparing for it. You are preparing for it. You are preparing for it. You are planning for it. And as you begin to do that, it brings joy. It brings focus to you in life. Now, I want us to look at the nature of genuine vision. What is a genuine vision? A genuine vision is critical or crucial to our existence. A genuine vision is crucial to our existence. Is crucial, is important to our existence. A genuine vision is crucial to our existence. Genuine vision is the answer to our limitations. What is the limitations around you? What is the limitations around you? A genuine vision is the answer to that limitation. Is the answer to that limitation. Is the answer to that limitation. That limitation around you. That limitation in your community. A genuine vision is the answer to that limitation. Genuine vision is the preview of what is to come. Genuine vision is the preview of what is to come. It's the preview of what is to come. You are expecting it. You anticipate it. And it definitely will come. A genuine vision converts your imagination into reality. Your imagination is being converted into a reality. That is the function of a genuine vision. A genuine vision is the capacity to see beyond the immediate. A genuine vision gives you the ability to begin to see beyond the immediate situations around you. No. You don't allow them to deter you. I remember years ago when I was living in a very pathetic environment. I was living in the bush in a mechanic workshop, and right there in the middle of the night with my books and my Bible placed on my chest, I said, Ben, how do you want to get out of this place? And I will always hear that voice, there's a way for you, there's a way for you, there's a way for you. And with those voices, with that intuition, with that divine instruction, with that divine whispering, with the whispering of the Holy Spirit, I begin to have hope that my future is going to be okay. I begin to have hope that my future is going to be okay. So vision is the capacity to see beyond the immediate. No matter what you're going through right now, vision helps you to see beyond the immediate. Vision is the mental image of a preferred future. It's the mental image of a preferred future. Today I will stop here, and the next time I come your way, I'll be talking about the ingredients of vision. The ingredients of vision. Thereafter, then we'll go into how to begin to run with the vision, how to protect your vision, and fulfilling your vision. So I want you to settle down and digest what you have heard tonight. I want you to play the tape over and over again and begin to ask yourself, what is that vision that you want to run your life with. What is that vision? What is that thing that will get you up early in the morning? You are not tired. You are not giving up. There are times I don't eat for a whole day and I'm not weak. I'm not tired. I'm just out there to live my life. I'm just out there to live my dream. I'm just out there to do the things that God has given me. So it's important for us to run with a vision. It's important for us to get a vision from God. Like I said, vision is the derivative of your purpose. You know your purpose, you know what God wants you to do. Then you are able to carve out a vision with the help of the Holy Spirit that helps you to live a fulfilling life. That helps you to live a fulfilling life. Thank you very much.